So a database will usually have several tables in it. Here's how we might start for our image voting app. The first table represents pictures people have uploaded of animals. The second represents people's votes. Fluffy, Monster, and George are all animals whose pictures someone has uploaded. Because we might have two animals with the same name, we give each one a numeric ID here. The pictures table says that Fluffy has ID 1, Monster has ID 2, George has ID 3, and so on. The votes table says which images have been displayed together for voting and which one the user picked as the cutest. Here, the app displayed Monster, ID 2, and George, ID 3, and the user voted for George. 2 and 3 were matched up, and 3 was the winner. Note that in the votes table, the columns are called left, right, and winner, but they match up to the column called ID in the pictures table. You can read every row as a sentence. In the pictures table, the sentences say Fluffy has ID number 1 and a file name fluffsocute.jpg, Monster has ID number 2 and file name monster-basket.png, and so forth. In the votes table, the sentences are picture 2 and picture 3 were displayed and the user voted for picture 3. Picture 1 and picture 3 were displayed and the user voted for picture 1, and so on. So this 3 and this 3 refer to the same thing, a cute critter with ID number 3. But they're in different tables, and the columns have different names, because they play different roles in different sentences. Over here, we're saying which picture has which ID. And over here, we're saying which ones have been displayed together and who got the vote. So this is the kind of sentence that this table actually represents. If we wanted to come up with sentences like Monster was shown with Fluffy and Fluffy got the vote, instead of 2 was shown with 1 and 1 got the vote for this row here, we would have to connect rows from this table with rows from that table. That's something we can do with a database query as well. Queries that do this are called joins, and we'll be seeing a lot of them later on in the course. For now, just remember that a value with the same meaning can occur in different tables and have different column names, and that we can derive new tables by linking up existing tables using joins.